In this video, I will show you the initial setup for Yawcam AI. When you open Yawcam AI for the first time, you need to create an admin account. After that, there are four more steps that need to be completed. And we're going to walk through them all right now. So let's begin with the admin account. Enter a username and a password. And confirm the password. It is not recommended to name the account admin or administrator. It is more secure to choose a different name, especially if you plan to make Yawcam accessible over the internet later on. With that said, let's click Create. At this step, we will start the download of the NVIDIA CUDA drivers. Just click on the download button. And these drivers are needed if we want to run the object detection on the graphics card. Right now, this is only possible with NVIDIA cards. There is no need to download the drivers if we plan to run the object detection on the CPU. But running it on the graphics card is much faster and uses less resources from the computer. The download will run in the background while we complete the rest of the steps. As default, the videos are stored in the user's home folder, but if we want, we can change that now. Just click Edit and modify the path as you like. I'm going to keep the default values for now, so I just click Cancel and on Next. At this step, we can add our cameras to Yawcam. Click on Add Device. To open the device wizard, give the camera a name and select a type. I'm going to select ONVIF because this is the easiest way to add a camera if it has ONVIF support. Now Yawcam will search for all ONVIF cameras on your local network. Keep in mind that some cameras need to have ONVIF enabled before they can be discovered. I will post another video showing an example of how to do that. When the search is done, we select the camera we want to add and click Next. Here we have to enter the username and password for the camera. If the camera supports multiple stream profiles, we select both a main and a substream. Yawcam will then test the device settings. And when everything works, we click Save. At this point, we can edit the camera we just added. Or even delete it. We can also add more cameras if we open the device wizard again. But for now, we are good with only this device, so we click Next. In the last step, we will wait for the CUDA drivers to be downloaded and validated. When the status has changed to available, we click on the restart button. If we didn't download the drivers, there is no need for this restart. But since we did the download, Yawcam needs a restart before the drivers can be used. Okay, the restart is done. We have now completed all the steps in the initial setup. Yawcam AI is now ready to use. So click OK. Since we just added a camera, there are no events listed on the start page. We need to go to the camera settings and enable the detector before events will be captured. But that is beyond the initial setup and will be covered in another video. So that's all for now. thanks for watching.